Hi everybody. Last I spoke to you about dismantling of Favorable Bajwas, and today we are going to talk on fault finding and assembling. How to find fault in the clocks that has stopped. Now I shall show you all the wheels that I have cleaned and kept here for you. You can take a look. The wheels are all here. The escape wheel, second wheel, third wheel, main wheel. This is the alarm side main wheel. This is the hammer. This is the escape wheel. And these are the two plates. Center wheel is here. Okay. Now these are the two springs. How do we clean these springs? Is, you know, make use of a tissue paper. Pull it, hold it at one edge and pull it through. You know, all the muck that is there, it will come into this. It will be like this. Okay. Same process you have to do for the alarm spring also. Hold it in this style, pull it through and leave it behind. All the muck comes into the tissue paper. Now what we have to do is, first we have to assemble and find out why the clock or timepiece has been stopping. We will assemble with the wheels, all the wheels put here without the springs. Now first we put the main wheel, then we put the third wheel. Okay, then we put the second wheel. Now we put the escape wheel here. Okay, these are the things that we really need to find out, because the working side is more important. If there are some faults in the alarm side, that can be rectified later, but first you have to check this side. Okay, now we are going to assemble this. Keep all the wheels in proper position. Hold the movement with your left hand. Okay, align the holes, hold it in this style. Okay, and make use of a tweezer that is here. Now make use of a tweezer and make use of the eyepiece if required. All that you have to do is pull all the wheels into their proper position. Okay, by just pushing it from one end. It will take hardly about half a minute. Now you can see all the wheels are spinning. You can see clearly, right? Now what we have to check here is, I shall definitely tell you, you have to look at these holes. 1, 2, 3. This one 4. Similarly on this side, you have to look here. 1, 2, 3. Okay. And this one 4. Now you have to find whether there are any play, whether there is play for these wheels. You know, play means actually having worn out, you know, part. The holes will be oblong in size. Now when you look at this, the wheels are not wobbling. That means this is in perfect condition. Supposing there is a wobble here or wobble here, there are two ways of fixing this. One is to put a bushing, as we do normally for the grinder mixer. Similarly, a small one, you know, these wheels, these bushings are available in the market, which we can use here. We have to pressure fit it here. Before we do that, I shall be telling you how to enlarge the holes and all after we complete this. Okay, now this is ready for assembling. That means you don't have to do any repair to the holes. Now I am going to undo this once again. Now all I have pulled out, all wheels I am putting out again once again. Now what we have to do here is bend these springs in this way, turn them clockwise and anti-clockwise as required. Okay, it should look like this. Okay, now we put the wheel into this. Turn this and see whether it is holding. It is. It is getting hooked in the arbor. Now, we have another wheel here, the main wheel, for which this spring is here. We have to wind it in the anti-clock direction. Why we need to do this is to accommodate all the wheels and the spring in the movement. Now, when this is ready, insert this wheel here and see whether it is holding. Yes, it is holding. When you move it manually with your fingers, you can find that the arbor is engaging. Okay. Now, in case it is slightly loose, you have to tighten it a bit with the help of a plier. There are 3-4 types of pliers. Use whichever one is convenient to you. And now, when you put the wheel in it and try to wind, you will find some resistance here. Now, this is ready for assembling. Now, what we have to do is assemble this. Put it in this type. Okay. Now put this one also here, the other spring onto this side. Okay, this is here. But what we have to do is put the alarm escape wheel here, put the hammer here, okay, in this style. Try to be a little careful that it is not falling off or coming out of place. Okay, this is here. Now we have to put the third wheel in position. Sometimes you may use the tweezer to put it in its proper place. It becomes easier when you put the tweezer. Okay. Now this wheel is there, the second wheel that goes here. Now then comes the escape wheel. Now, since you have found that there are no faults in the plates, you put the lever also into it. This is known as the lever, as I told you. Now put the lever in its place. Make use of the tweezer. It will be more convenient. Okay. Now put the plate over it carefully. Ensure that the wheels are not knocked off in the process. Give a slight shake to the plate and align the main wheels first. Align all the four studs that are here. Push the plate. When this is done, you have to start moving them once again. With the help of the tweezer, you are assembling it, pulling all the wheels back into the proper holes. Apply a little pressure on the plate so that holes will slide in comfortably. It takes just a minute, not more. All the wheels are in place, you can see. Okay, there is no movement. All the wheels are in place. Now we have to start putting the nuts on it. Okay, we'll put the nuts here and they should be hand tight only. Don't make use of the plier to tighten it, because we have to wind it also and check how the action is from the lever. Okay, now this you can see, everything is put in place. Now When this is done, you have to make use of the key for winding this. Okay. Now I am going to wind the spring. You can see, hold it this way, the finger on this side, thumb on the top side, and start winding. Okay, wind it till the last means till the entire spring goes into the movement. Okay, when it is in place, insert this with your hand and push it inside. Okay, it should sit like this, you know, properly snug closer. Now we take the other key and wind this alarm side spring in first to check the alarm side whether it is working or if it has any snag in it. Now wind it fully. Okay, insert it here. Okay, wind it further. Okay, try out the alarm, it will strike like this. Okay, you can see it is moving smoothly, there is no complaint. Now what we need to do further, now we have to put this part. You have already seen this. This is a click. This prevents. Take out the key first so that you get more space for inserting this. This you have to insert here. Okay. Put it in this. Slightly, slowly pull it and set the click in place. What this does is, this prevents this particular rod from going along with the our hand. This has locked, this won't move. You can see it moves in one direction only. This acts as a lock also. Now what you have to do now is put the balance into its place. This is the balance. Okay, this is properly clean. The balance, this bearing screw is undone a bit, few threads. We are putting this balance into this. Okay, hold it with your thumb, insert it into the impulse pin should come into the lever, and the impulse pin should enter the lever. Okay, and then you start tightening the bearing screw. Bearing screw is the part that helps the balance wheel to rotate or oscillate, okay, from one direction to the other. Now when this is done, sometimes it becomes difficult to push it with the hand. There you make use of the plier. There should be some gap. Check the gap, you know, between the two bearing screws. If it is, this is too much, so it should be less than this. You have to reduce it by tightening it further. Now you can see there is still gap. You can give, always take two or more times to set it correctly. Don't tighten it at the first attempt, you may damage the points of the balance. Okay, when this is done, make sure there is play. It can be tightened a little bit further. Now pushing the regulator to this side, pull the balance wheel. You can see the hair spring here. Insert it into the regulator, turn the balance wheel and set the hair spring in the regulator correctly. Then turning this, hold it in this style and lift the hair spring and insert it into the hole that is here. There is a stud like thing in which you have to insert this. Okay, now picking up this pin what we had taken out earlier, we are going to fix the pin here. Now the moment you put, you have to wind it a bit so that there will be movement in the timepiece. Okay, you can see it is functioning. Okay, this is assembly part. Now I shall show you what further things you need to do here to complete the assembly. Now we have to make use of this part, put it here. You know, there is a notch here, it will go into this and comes down like this. Okay, now we have to put the minute wheel. This is the minute wheel. Okay, then we put the hour wheel, then we put the alarm setting wheel. Okay, we push it down, hold it like this, then insert a pin to prevent it from coming out. This is the pin we had taken out earlier. Same pin can be used. If the pin is damaged, you have to change the pin. Pin is put, secure it by slightly making use of the plier. Now you pick up the C lock that we had taken out earlier from this wheel. Okay, you can press it, make use of a plier. Okay, this is in place. This will prevent the wheel from coming out. Now after this, I have to set the dial in place. This is the dial, this is cleaned and kept. I have to set the dial here. Okay, this has four notches here. You know, you have to hold it this way, set one side first, the lower or upper side you can set once. Okay, then pull this a bit, set this one, then pull out this one. The dial is set. Now all the four studs are in place. Now you have to put the alarm setting hand. It comes in here. It is, I have to put this way and press it with the tweezer. It sits. Okay, it is not moving. Now how to set the, how to synchronize the hands now is what I am going to tell you. You have to insert this time setting button, turn it anti-clockwise, it runs, it makes the alarm setting hand also to the right hour you need. Normally it is set with 9, 6, 3 and 12 will the time we take, because it becomes easier to align it. Now take the hour hand. Okay, make use of the plier, or even you can set it with the hand also. Then make use of this other hand, put it over, set it exactly at 12, then press it down. Okay, the hand is in place. Now you can turn this and see. Okay, now what we are trying to see is, now it is, it shows 12 o'clock. Okay, we wind this a bit, the alarm side, to test the alarm. Now wind once or twice. Now turn the alarm setting hand. Now we are moving the alarm setting hand to 12 o'clock. You can see there is some variation in this. You can see that variation can be rectified here by turning this. Okay, the way difference is slightly, bring it to 9 here. You can easily push this a bit here. Okay, it is exactly at 9 now. Now we turn it, once again and see, it stops at 9. You can hear the ticking sound. This is all about assembly. Now after this, you have to put it into the case, oil it and put it into the case. A bit of oil for the balance and bearing screw, little bit of oil for the springs, and little bit of oil for the gears, okay, and a little bit of oils for the alarm spring, and thereafter you can complete. Assembly is complete now. You can hear the bell striking, okay, alarm going on, okay. This is how you have to assemble it. Any further queries, please comment. We shall be happy to revert to you. If you like this
chapter,
the assembling is complete. Now I am sure you will like what I have shown, and you will press the subscribe and press the bell icon. See you in the next video.